And of course, they feel the need to tell us how to save normally. But whatever. Let's see what the next day has for us. And of course, just because it's our day off doesn't mean we can sleep in. Tallow, Mallow, and Beth have decided to wake us up for some hopefully very, very good reason. But first, let's see what Link has in his basement. Oh, fuck if I can tell. We'll come back later when we can light this place up. Outside, in addition to those three kids, is also Colin, whom I will completely forget to talk to in this video, but we'll meet him next video. Alright, now let's see what those fucking brats want. A slingshot. You woke us up on our day off for a frickin' slingshot. Well, and of course, you're going to be too cheap to buy it yourselves. Then again, I doubt those three could use a slingshot without killing someone, so it's up to us to be the responsible ones and buy the slingshot before they put somebody's eye out. I decide not to head back to the spring to grind up some rupees, and decide instead to explore town a little, see if there are any jobs we can do to earn a little bit of income. Up ahead we have Hanch. He is Beth's father, and the husband of Sarah, who is the proprietor of the store. He's got a bit of a bee problem, which will inevitably be taken care of. And in fact, we'll be getting to that quite soon. This house is quite locked, and I don't know why. Over here we have Sarah's sundries. As I said, it was the town store. Unfortunately, Sarah's feeling a bit down. Her cat's gone missing, and even though he has not left the village, he keeps running away. So, yeah, she won't sell us anything until her cat's back. Let's go do this shit. Over here we have the obligatory altarding tutorial, as well as a vine climbing tutorial. Of course, these are, you know, kind of standard to any Zelda game. The cat's just over there, huh? Sarah can't go get it herself. Oh well. Over there we have the second type of grass in this game that we can whistle through, the hawk grass. Let's see what it does. As if the name wasn't any indication. Once we summon a hawk, we can aim it at something, and it will dash at it at immense speed. Let's try knocking down that beehive, shall we? That did it. Of course, now there's getting down, and Link's got a bit of a height. Oh, no. Never mind. No height problems. Alright. Reward, please. Give us a reward. No reward. Damn it. Well, this over here is a bee larva. You can scoop them up with a bottle, but unfortunately, we do not yet have one. And after I trip off the cliff trying to get those rupees, we'll meet Uli, Colin's mother, and Russell, the swordsman mentor that we were talking to at the start of the video, is her husband. She has misplaced her cradle, and of course it'll be up to us to find it. Over here we have Mayor Bo, and every time we talk to him, Fado will accidentally let a goat loose. Let's try to stop it. Come on. Come on over here. Ah, damn it. Fortunately, there are an unlimited number of goats, and we can try again until we succeed. In order to stop a goat, all we have to do is stand in front of it and hold down A when it gets close. We're locked into strafe mode for this part, and once we grab it, it's a simple matter of twisting the controller to the control stick to the side. Alright, let's go see what Ilya's up to. Secrets, huh? Well, I suppose we'll find out eventually. Before we go looking for the cradle, let's go check out Russell, Uli, and Colin's house. Seeing as how all three family members are currently out at the moment, there is absolutely nothing in here. But it's still nice to look at. Outside the house, however, is something far more important for us right now. Pumpkins. We need those rupees because who knows how much that slingshot will cost. I'm guessing probably around 10 rupees. It's not too expensive. It's gotta be pretty cheap considering it's only a toy. And there are only one pumpkin patch by the house. Now when we were up there with the hawk grass, I thought I saw something in the distance down the river. So let's see if we can see what's over there. Let's send a hawk to scout, shall we? Definitely sounds like I can hear something. And you can make out something moving over there. And there's the cradle. Don't know what that monkey wanted with that, but let's just return it to Uli. Hold on a sec. If the cradle falls in the river, you can just push it over to where the pier is. Because contrary to what Uli hinted at earlier, there's no actual current here. And once you get it over the edge, it's a simple matter of getting close enough to get the pickup prompt to appear again. Alright, maybe this time we can get a reward. Ah, sweet. Finally get our reward. But she's taking forever. Come on, we need that slingshot. If we don't buy that slingshot, then kids will get hurt. I'm not saying I will hurt them. I am saying they will hurt each other. Come on, go faster. I know you're pregnant and all, but that's no excuse. Oh, thank God. Reward, please. A fishing rod. Well, I suppose we'll have to make do with it. Might be able to sell fish. Colin made that, huh? We'll have to thank him when I remember to talk to him next episode. Alright, well, you know what? Cats like fish. Maybe we can get the slingshot for free if we return the cat to Sarah. And after I forget that the river does not run behind Maribo's house, I will head over to the actual place where you're supposed to fish. If you need to find more rupees, there are plenty of pumpkins in this area. And of course, if you go back to your house and come back into the village, then they will reload. If you press the A button while highlighting an item, it'll give you a short blurb on how to use the item. Unfortunately, I did not quite read that blurb, and I forgot how to pull a fish out of the water. So after pausing the game to consult the instruction manual, I found out that you have to hold down on the C stick in order to get the fish to come out. So let's do that. Now, the reason why this is still sped up is because at this point the cat starts following us, and I thought that we had to lure the cat back to the shop in order to get the cat to enter the shop. But unfortunately, I was mistaken. You're supposed to catch two fish. Now, entering the shop does not reset this, and I don't think anything resets this. So, we shall proceed to catch the second fish as though nothing happened. And there it goes. Alright, we are one step closer to getting that slingshot and saving eyes everywhere. After a quick journey back to the shop, we can claim our reward. Yeah, real cute. We got a bottle. Well, that's better than a slingshot. But we still need to get the slingshot. So let's just see how much it costs real quick. Like I said, it's a toy, so it's probably something a little cheap. Milk's 10, larva's 10, and oh geez, that's 30. Well, we don't quite have that just yet, but I will get that off camera, and we will begin the second episode with 30 rupees in hand. So, until then, I will see you later.